talk about this next story because this is becoming too rampant in Nigeria, and again, it could happen to anybody. Another demolition happened in Lagos without warning. 16 properties at Lagoon View Estate in Ikorodu were demolished. Now, this is not even a slum, and I'm not saying that it's right for the government to destroy slums, but these are people who bought land and built houses on the land. You didn't sue them when they bought the land. You didn't say anything when they were building the homes. You waited until they're already living in some of the homes, and all of a sudden, you show up and you demolish the place. Like, who does that? This only happens in Nigeria, and it needs to stop. Those who got notice said that it was posted on a rainy day, 6 days to the demolition, that they should leave. Now, most of the owners said that they didn't get any notice, and it's possible that it was washed away by the rain, I don't know. But whether they serve notice or not, that is not how you do it. You don't just post something on the wall and in 6 days' time start destroying people's homes. Why do we have courts in Nigeria? Apparently, a very rich person who has refused to show his face or her face till now was the one that claimed that he or she bought the land where the estate is located. 30 years ago, and because of that, the Lagos State Government Ministry of Physical Planning and Urban Development sent 36 soldiers, fully armed, and about 50 area boys to escort their men to go and demolish these people's houses. And now they've been protesting.
They came with armed men on the 16th of August and they demolished our property. We have been living in this place for many, many years. And we have several properties to the tune of over ₦1 billion that was brought down by bulldozers. As of yet, we do not know who is responsible for this. Neither do we know who is taking our land.
Of country is this where you buy the land from the government, you build a house, and then someone from nowhere will show up and say that they bought the land 30 years ago. Sometimes you pay the government, but you still have to pay our money. You know, some people call them land grabbers. These are people that will come and say that their great 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 grandfather was the one that owned the land. So you understand? So you pay the government, you have to pay people. It's so sad what people are going through. A lot of innocent people are suffering. And how do you tell me that the government has not been compromised in this case? Because we still don't know the person claiming to own this land, but government officials went there to demolish the house with the soldiers as escort. Eyewitnesses said that when the soldiers came, that they were drunk and that they kept shooting as the demolition was going on, preventing homeowners from taking pictures or filming the demolition. Unconfirmed sources said that the soldiers had been bribed with ₦5 million. I don't know how true that is, but they must have been paid something for them to come and demolish the homes. Now, there was one woman that day that said that she was nursing a 2-month-old baby, and when she realized that the house was being demolished, by the time she ran out to check what was happening and come back to pick up her baby, she said that she barely made it out alive. Now, this is not peculiar to Lagos or Abuja. Did you not hear about what happened in Owerri at Eke-Ukwu Owerri Market? Soldiers came in, police, they came in to demolish the market in broad daylight. Now, they said that they've served these people notice for a long time. I'll still talk about that later. But how do you demolish a market in broad daylight when you know that people will be there to sell, to buy? And then, on top of that, they were shooting sporadically. Do you know that 3 people were reportedly killed that day? The government is denying it, but at least we saw the picture of a 10-year-old boy that was shot. Seriously, is that really necessary? Police shooting anyhow, soldiers shooting anyhow, when you know that people are dead? And before I go on, let me just say, my people, please, if you've been served notice, please don't keep quiet. Don't say, oh, maybe they won't. They will come to demolish the place. You need to take action. If you get any notice, whether you deserve it or you don't deserve it, that's when you go to your lawyer, that's when you go to the government house. As a matter of fact, go to town planning, the town planning office. Make sure that the property that you bought or the land that you bought is not in violation of any physical planning by the government. Do not ignore any notice. You know, Nigerian government, they will do whatever they say they want to do. They will come, they will demolish. So don't ignore it. And don't wait. Don't wait until they demolish. Now, for the people whose homes were demolished in Lagos, some of the property owners are living in the US. Now, these people are going crazy here in the US because they just don't understand how someone can just show up and demolish their property without suing them or without them getting any notice. I spoke with one of them building a hotel, and the hotel is already at roofing level. This woman said, Adeola, this is the money saved from 11 years of laboring in America, working in winter time and in summer time. She told me that her security guard guard that she put at the property as soon as the soldiers came and they started demolishing. Her security guard picked up his phone to call her here in the US, and the soldiers took his phone, and not just that, they bundled him and put him in their truck. Can you imagine? Another of the property owners in that same estate lives here in New York. The man said that he only decided to go and build in Nigeria because the senior special assistant on foreign affairs and diaspora came to the US and said that Nigerians abroad should come and invest back home, that things are now working. He said that is why he invested though. Now the man is in shock. You know how hard it is to make money in this America. You can't just embezzle money like some people will do in Nigeria. No offense, but you basically have to work hard for your money. Now for you to work so hard for 11 years and invest in Nigeria and you get the call someday, all your investment is gone. Can you imagine? For real, it would be good for the government to have a way of ensuring people that if you come to invest back home, your investment will be protected, especially if you are not connected to powerful people. Sure, you understand. Now the government of Lagos must listen to the cries of these people, and not just them, so many others that are in their situation. The government needs to handle the land issue thing better than they are doing, and Governor Okorocha needs to stop telling people that nobody died. We are seeing pictures of the boy that was killed, and the governor is still insisting that nobody died. Hey, Berolanwo! Also, my people, please, you need to be very careful when you are buying a land, especially in Lagos, in Abuja, anywhere. First of all, make sure that you get your C of O before you even start building. It has come to that point. But you know, sometimes even that doesn't help. Like the woman that was building the hotel in Nigeria, she said that her C of O had been approved before they demolished her house. She even sent me all the documents that they have sent her. Upon all of it, Inko, they destroyed her property. You know, when some people tell me that they don't want to go back to Nigeria, I don't blame them, because you don't know people's stories. But you know, it doesn't have to be like that, and hopefully these people get justice. And you know, for the family members of those that were killed when they demolished the market in Owerri, I just cannot imagine what they're going to. It doesn't make any sense at all. You guys not doing much. Guess what, I'm just keeping it real.